And in designing the processor, we are given the instruction set architecture, instruction format. We need to decide the data path, control, and we have different styles. We have the basic single cycle, and at this point, we are looking into a pipeline design, right? Because we said that in computer architecture, we can improve performance by doing some pipeline, because there are portions in the data path that sometimes, as the execution of the instruction progresses, are no longer used. So you can take advantage of that, right? So reminder, the exam is on Wednesday. I suggest, again, yung mga style ko sa pagpagawa ng exam is I basically lift questions from the end of chapter exercises in the textbook. So today is Friday, so you can download the textbook online. You should have that and try to solve some of the problems, okay, over the weekend. So weekend pa naman ako gagawa ng ng exam. Okay. So the coverage will be until the introduction to pipelining, not the details of the LEGV8 pipeline architecture. Okay? So for today, we're going to proceed. So until this point, the exam will be until this point. Summary. Okay, so what we're currently designing is we're designing the pipeline, the data path for the LEGV8 instructions and architecture. So again, our processor, our input is the instruction and architecture. You are tasked to build the processor for that. And we start with the pipeline data path. So normally, we said last time that in the LEGV8, we can divide the pipeline into five stages. You have the instruction fetch, denoted as IF, instruction decode, and the register file read as ID, and execute, EX, MEM, and WB. So it's important that you remember this, because we will be referring to these stages along the way. Okay, so normally the movement is from right from left to right. Okay, so you have the program counter. If you set that to zero, okay, so etc., you get the instruction from the memory. Okay, and then there are two backwards flow. Okay, the first one is the right back, wherein the output, the final output here, can be written to the register file, and the program counter, okay, will be written back, okay, to the for the next instruction execution. Okay, so this is the basic pipeline design. So somehow, even though when we were designing the single cycle data path, parang built in na sa kanya na, oh, madali lang i-pipeline to, itong processor design na to, or itong instruction set architecture, yung LEGV8 na to, madali lang i-pipeline to, kasi parang konting rearrangement lang, lagyan mo lang ng guhit dyan, you can actually create the pipeline. And the idea of pipelining is, if this stage is completed, then other instruction can actually take advantage of the circuitry, okay, while another instruction is in this stage. Okay? That's the idea of pipelining. Now, as you move along this, as you move along these stages, yung first instruction mo, your first instruction will be executing at this stage. Then, and the next clock cycle, it will execute in this next stage. Okay? And other instructions will use this stage. So there must be a way for you to be able to store whatever data was generated from the previous stage you should be able to store them so that they can be used in the next stage. That's why you need to have registers between stages. Parang ano yan, parang temporary memory. Ang analogy nga yan dun sa book is, di ba yung wash, paglalaba yung, ano natin, paglalaba yung, tawag dito, analogy natin ng pipelining. Yung vertical bars na yan, siya yung parang basket, di ba? Pag nag-washing machine ka, siyempre may basket dapat kayo. From the washing machine, so, didrain nyo yun, kung puno pa yung ano, kung puno pa yung, may laman pa yung parang yung dryer, lalagay nyo mo sa basket, di ba? Right? So, yun yung idea nitong register na to. Para, after nitong stage na to, okay, the data, for example here, the program counter and the instruction, they will be stored in the, we call these pipeline registers, okay? So, we call these pipeline registers, and how do we name these pipeline registers? By the boundaries, since they are parang ang tawag na, parang boundary register. So halimbawa, IF saka ID. Ang tawag sa boundary or pipeline register niya will be IF/ID. Okay? So the notation is previous next. Okay? So you also have to remember that, because when we talk about the hazards, the specific hazards, automated detection of hazards, right, we're going to refer to this notation. So IF, ID, boundary between instruction decode, etc., etc. And notice that we only have 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? We don't have a last one, a last register, pipeline register here, because it goes back here. Okay, you get the idea? So essentially, it's almost automatic from the single cycle design with single cycle data path, we can create a pipeline data path by just introducing the different stages and separating different stages with pipeline registers. Okay, so the next step now is how do we visualize the operation of a pipeline architecture, right? So normally you do that by cycle by cycle flow of instructions through the pipeline data path. There are actually two ways to visualize this. The first one is called the single clock cycle pipeline diagram. Okay, it shows the pipeline usage in a single cycle, and basically it highlights the resources used. When you say resources, ito yon, yung mga functional components like the instruction memory, the register file, the ALU, others, and the data memory, and of course the pipeline registers, right? And another one is a multi-clock cycle diagram, which is a graph of the operation over time. You're going to see these two types of visualization of pipeline instruction execution in a pipeline architecture. So, in the book, they started with the single clock cycle, right? Single clock cycle diagram for two specific instructions, load and store. Why load and store? Because load and store, they utilize all the resources in the data path. Ibig sabihin, lahat ng functional units dinadaanan niya hanggang sa kaduluhan. Actually, in the case of load, right, yung store hanggang dito lang siya eh. So again, you have to recall, no? You have to recall yung load. Ano bang ginagawa ng load instruction? Ano yung syntax niya? LDUR, first parameter register. So, sige, ano na lang natin? I-review na lang natin. Where is that? Okay, so ito yung... Okay, so this is the instruction format. Okay, so you have the load or store instruction. So, ito yung tatandaan niyo. Ito yung papasok doon sa pipeline na instruction. Okay? So, yung parts niya, so you have RN, RT. This is the immediate offset, or the offset, immediate value, the operand, immediate operand. Okay? And this is the opcode. Okay? So, we call that... Okay, so we now start with the IF for load store. So pareho lang halos yung first few stages ng load in store. So IF is instruction fetch. Okay? So LDUR is the instruction in the instruction fetch, right? So again, our notation pag grade siya or highlighted, ibig sabihin active siya during that cycle, okay? So remember na bakit may hati-hati yan? Dahil nga may hati-hati yan kasi yung left part is for writing, doing writing, tapos yung right part ay you are doing reading. Okay? So remember, edge triggered yung ating processor, okay? So nagpe-perform lang siya ng operation, positive edge trigger when there is a transition in the clock from low volt to high volt, okay? So yeah. So kaya kumbaga pwede mong built in na yung synchronization, okay? Built in na yung synchronization if you have an edge triggered system, okay? So for the LDUR, okay, so if you, this will be the active elements or active resources, so you have the multiplexer, the program counter, okay, so because it contains the address, okay, and then you have the instruction memory, so read, and then you have the add here for the next instruction, okay, get the idea. So again, diba sa branch instruction, bakit kailangan ng multiplexer dito, okay? So because there are two possible options. One is pag ordinary next instruction lang, i-increment mo lang yung program counter by 4. Or if you performed a branch, okay, may offset 'yon, dito manggagaling yung ano, yung address na kukunin mo. Okay? So program counter and then papasakyan dito, and yung program counter, sabi ko kanina, pagkatapos sa stage na to, kailangan i-store siya dun sa IF/ID register, okay? So notice na naka-highlight yung right part, okay? So sa stage na to, kailangan nagra-write dun sa IF/ID pipeline register kasi ang i-store mo doon yung program counter and the instruction word. Kung ano yung instruction na iyan mo, which in our case is LDUR. Okay? So, papasok yan dito. Okay? Then, on the next step, instruction decode. Okay? So, in the instruction decode, it's the next step. Okay? So, disable na. So, notice na at this point, itong area na to, pwede ni siyang gamitin nung next instruction. Kung halimbawa, add yung next instruction mo, si add, pwede na siyang mag-execute dito. May get the idea for pipelining. Okay? So, sa instruction decode, so anong ginagawa niyan? So, LDUR halimbawa yung code mo, yung instruction na ina-execute mo. So, again, the program counter will be forwarded to this next pipeline register, IDEX. Now, since load yan, meron kang registers. Okay? So, you need to access the read registers. Actually, pag nag-load ka, ang parameter mo, dalawang parameter mo, okay, register 1 and register 2, okay? So, yun, iluload, i-ano mo yan, i-forward mo yan dun sa, ano, sa IDEX na pipeline register. Now, kahit wala ka namang i-extend, pwedeng gawin mo na yan, okay? So, you can use that, okay, for sign extension, okay? So, that's the second stage. And then, the third stage, okay, is the execution stage, okay? So again, disabled na yung write, pwede nang gamitin to ng previous instruction, ito pwede na rin gamitin, okay? So this one, kumbaga, ang idea dito is, sa bawat stage ng execution ng instruction, kailangan lahat ng information niya na kung halimbawa wala kang pipelining na diretso mong na-access, kailangan ma-save mo siya dito, okay? Nandito na lahat dapat ng information na para ma-perform mo yung computation. So here, nandito na yung ano, yung program counter, yung register na na-read mo, and yung offset. So ni-write mo yan dito, and you're going now to perform the load operation. So basically, you're going to use the ALU, and then okay, you get the idea, and then accessing the, since you are loading, when you load, you access data from the memory and put it in the register, so you will be able to generate, okay? So yung ALU, kailangan mo ma-compute yung effective address, tinatawag, kung saan sa memory kukunin talaga, okay? Di ba yung syntax natin ng load ay nasa square bracket, tapos may base register ka, comma, tapos yung offset, di ba? Yung value ng base register, i-add mo dun, i-add mo dun sa sign extended na ano, na sign extended na offset, okay? Kasi yung size, remember na yung size ng our size, the size of the registers in leg V8 is 64 bit. Tapos dun sa instructions at architecture ng LDUR, yung offset ay 32 bits lang, okay? So kailangan i-sign extend mo siya para maging 64 bit para magamit mo siya sa ALU para makuha mo yung effective address dun sa memory. Okay. Pag nakuha mo na yon, okay, dito na tayo sa memory, ilalabas yan dito. Okay. So again, naka-store dapat dito. Okay. Kung branch instruction yan, pwede nang dito. Pero we are talking about load. So nandito, ito yung mga active elements niya. So lalabas na ngayon dito, i-emit na yung value na nakuha doon sa effective memory address. And then the last stage will be the write back. Okay. So the write back, okay, the write back, okay, ito na yung ilalagay mo na sa register. Okay? Ito yung ilalagay mo na pagbalik sa register. So, again, LDUR X2, X3, hash, 40. Ito yung example natin in a pipeline runner. So, X3, 64-bit. This one is 32-bit, sign extend mo, i-add mo, yun yung address sa memory, yun yung kukunin niya dito, ilalabas niya yan, tapos ilalagay niya dito. You get the idea? Okay. Now, sabi dito, there is a wrong register number. Bakit wrong register number yan? Okay. Bakit? Kasi, sa execution natin ng LDUR, nandito na tayo sa dulo. Okay? Now, kung nandito na sa dulo ng stage, yung execution ng LDUR, meron na ibang gumagamit nito stage na to. Diba? Diba? Yun yung idea natin ng ano eh. Yung idea natin ng pipelining. Kung nandito rin sa stage na to, meron ng ibang instruction na gumagamit na nag-execute sa stage na to. Tama ba? Do you agree? Or no? Or no? Tama, dapat. Assume na lang yung tama yung sinasabi ko. Ibig sabihin, isa yung laman niya dito. Okay? Ang problema natin kasi ay hindi natin ipinasa yung write register doon sa pipeline register. So ito yung solution ko. Okay? Kasi pagdating ito sa dulo, nalimutan mo na, wala doon sa circuitry natin, nalimutan mo na yung write register. Nalimutan mo na si X2. Okay? Kung nandun ka na sa dulo, kung hindi mo inalian ng ganito. So, the solution is, at this point, sa stage na to, so, instruction decode, ipasa mo na rin doon sa pipeline register yung X2. Para pagdating sa dulo, alam mo na X2 yan. Yun yung nandito mo. You get the idea? So, that's what we mean by the corrected data path. Okay? So, sa load, sa store, ganun din. Halos pareho lang yung first part ng ano ng store. So, yung store naman, so, hindi na pinakita yung ano. Ito, pinakita na to yung IF for load and store, ID for load and store. Ang pinagkaiba lang nila ay doon na isa, ano na, sa execute na. This is the store instruction. STUR naman yan. STUR. So, opposite lang yung ano niya. Opposite lang yung same format, pero opposite yung behavior niya. Okay? So, again, yun yung i-active sa kanya. Okay? So, kailangan niya rin mag-compute ng address. Okay? Kung saan ilalagay yung data. Okay? And then, that. Okay? So write siya kasi nag-aano siya, naglalagay siya sa memory kung ano man yung data niya. Okay? And then kung ano yung register data, okay? And then wala siyang gagawin sa write back. Okay? Kasi dalawa siyang ibang dito. Okay, good idea. Okay. So does the instruction, does the store instruction still need to go to the STUR? To the write back stage, kahit wala siyang gagawin doon. Oo, kasi may mga iba nang gumagamit diyan eh. So hindi niyo pwedeng tanggalin yan na para mag-shortcut na lang siya. Okay? Kasi may iba nang mga gumagamit diyan. Okay? So that is the example. So this is a single clock cycle visualization of pipeline execution using the load and store. Okay? Now, another way to visualize pipelining is yung multi-cycle pipeline diagram. So, it basically kumbaga mas high level right, compared to single cycle. Kasi sa single cycle ang pinapakita doon yung activation ng bawat resource or ng bawat functional unit. Okay. So dito, makikita nyo ay sa parang 2D diagram. Okay. So the x-axis top is labeled with clock cycles, and then you have the instructions, and then you have the different components. Okay. So instruction memory, IM, instruction memory, register file, ALU, data memory, and register function. So this is another view. Okay. So halimbawa, sa LDUR X10, X1 number 40, okay. So ito yung mga cycle 1, ito yung active niya sa instruction memory to. Kasi diba, yung instruction work kailangan forward mo dun sa, ano, sa register file. Ito yung pipeline register mo. Okay. So at this point, since wala naman itong data hazard, okay, kita niyo walang data hazard, kasi X10 yung ginamit niya, X1, ito X11, X2, X3. So, at clock cycle 2, pwede na active yung execution ng instruction na ito sa instruction memory. You get the idea? Okay. So, yan. Ganun lang yung way ng sobrano. Nagpag-execute sa kanya kapag nag-view mo siya in a pipeline manner. Okay? So this is the multi-cycle pipeline. This one is single cycle. Okay? So traditional form. Ito kasi medyo mahirap i-drawing. Okay? Medyo mahirap i-drawing. So ito na lang. Traditional form. Box lang. Diba? So yung main difference ng dalawa is yung itong illustration na to, ang pinapakita dito ay yung parang dalawang version ng multi-cycle. Multi-cycle pipeline. The first one is this one, pinapakita yung individual resource. Okay. Dito naman, yung traditional form, same din, pero ang pinapakita yung pipeline stage. Okay, you get the idea? You get the difference? Ano, mas madaling yung drawing. Depende actually sa need mo. Okay? When we analyze data hazards later, okay, mas maganda to kasi makakita mo yung drawing, yung forwarding na gagawin later, okay, in the case of leg DA. Okay? So, for the single cycle pipeline diagram, so ito yun.
Ito yung sinasabi ko kanina, no? Yung LDUR na lang. Kanina, sabi ko yung LDUR, kanina, nandito na sa dulo. Pero minimension ko na yung ibang components dito may nakasalan na ng ibang instruction. Okay? So, in the single cycle pipeline diagram, yung heading mo or yung x-axis mo, doon nakalagay yung instruction na naging execute doon sa stage na yun. You get the idea? So, if you have a sequence of instructions,
so ito yata yung instruction na yan. Okay. So ito yung example na ginagamit niya.
You have a sequence of instructions, anong itsura niya doon sa data pack?
Okay? Pag isinalang mo sila, ito yung mangyayari.
Okay? Kung nasa dulo na si LDUR, kasi magkakasunod-sunod yan, nandito na yung, nandito yung soap, nag-execute sa memory, yung add, nag-execute sa dito, yung LDUR, nag-execute na dito, yung add, nag-execute.
Get the idea? So parang may component reuse dito, ng idea ng pipeline.
Kaya sabi ko kanina na kailangan, pag nag-execute na si LDUR for example, lahat ng kailangan niya ay nakastore na doon sa pipeline register. Kasi iba na ang gumagamit ng ibang component, di ba? So kanina, yung bug kanina, hindi mo ini-store yung write register dito sa mga wala to. Kung wala to, tapos na sa LDUR ka na, iba ang value ng write register dito.
You get the idea? So, that is what we mean by the single cycle pipeline diagram. Okay? Okay. So, we're done with, is the pipeline data path, how it operates, how to visualize it clear already. Okay? So, the next stage, the next part in the design of the processor is the control part. Okay? So, the control part, of course, will be something similar. Okay? So in the same manner that we designed the pipeline control. So let's go back a little to, baka nakalimutan nyo na, review na rin to sa ano, sa yan, sa, okay, sa control. Okay? So, sa control, sabi natin,
dalawa yung main component na kayo dito sa design natin, you need two control units. One is for the ALU, and the other one is for the entire
processor, okay? So for the ALU control, ito yung ano natin, yung design natin. Kasi kumbaga yung ALU natin is a reusable component. It is used by load and store, arithmetic instruction, jump instruction. So kailangan mo mag-specify ng control of kung ano yung gagawin niya. So you basically need to have control lines for that. And this is how we design that. Right? In a non-pipeline, single cycle unit. Right? And this is actually the final output kung single cycle lang siya. Right?
So remember, yung mga control lines. Right? So, ito, kailangan ng control line dito. Dito, kailangan ng control line dito. Control line dito. Kung mag-write ka sa memory. Dito ko magbabranch ka, okay?
So yung mga blue parts with yung control lines for the single cycle data path. So when we go to the pipeline control, halos ganun din yung gagawin natin. And the first step is of course to label. Okay? We have to label asan yung mga nangangailangan ng control lines. Okay? So this figure here illustrates how halos pareho lang siya. May reg-tulog, reg-write, ALU control, yung ALU off, ALU source, memorize, memory, etc. So, how many lines about that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 to 10. May control lines ang kailangan mong determine. So actually, ang ginagamit dyan ay parang, are you familiar with decoder in 130? O yung decoder, may inputs ka, tapos may output lines ka, diba? Kung 3 input lines, 2 to the 3, that will be 8 output lines. Okay? So ganun yung basically yung gagawin when you design. Although there are other advanced techniques for designing control unit, but the decoder is one component that can be used in designing the control unit. Okay. Kasi dito, ellipse lang yung pinakita, di ba, sa ano, sa design ng control unit. But inside it, nasa appendix C ng textbook, dun dinidiscuss kung paano i-design talaga at the circuit level yung control unit. Okay? So, what you're going to do is to simply isasama muna. Okay? Di ba, meron ka na ditong pipeline registers. Okay? What you simply need to do is to simply include that
yung mga control lines na yon, ipapasa mo na doon sa, isama mo na doon sa pipeline
reference. Right? And yung label niya, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 control lines. Okay? So from the instruction, after the instruction fetch, instruction decode na, di ba? Sisingit mo na din yung control unit, input mo sa control unit yung instruction word, yung 32-bit na instruction word, hihimay-himay nyo ng control unit, ano yung opcode, okay, ano yung operands, and then isiset niya kung ano yung appropriate lines dun sa control link. And then, dito, may mga, kumbaga, igugroup mo lang yung mga control lines na gagamitin for each stage. Okay? So, write back memory execute, write back memory, kasi tapos ka na sa execute, and then write back. So, this is actually how that will look now. Okay? Kita niyo?
So, ito yung instruction word, papasok din sa control unit. Okay? Okay, so,
pinunta rin po sila. Okay, get the idea? And, ano yung mga lines? Kung baga, green up lang siya dito, ano yung mga lines na kailangan dyan? Okay. Meron ba dito? Wala. Hindi. Walang figure dito, pero hindi pala na isama sa dito, walang table. Okay? So, ano yung mga lines? The lines can, halimbawa, tayo sa kodigo. Yung siyam na control lines can be grouped into ilan yan? 1, 2, 3. So, tatlong parts. So, halimbawa, sa right back, okay?
Sulat ko na lang. Sample lang ito. Nasa book naman ito. Nasa right back.
Yung control lines na kailangan mong i-activate sa right back are, basically, i-group mo lang, okay? Right back, wrench right. Sa command to wrench. Okay. Sa right back, okay?
Di ba sa right back, kailangan mong sulat, LD or kailangan mong ibalik dito sa register file. So, kailangan mo, sa grouping ng right back, yung right, red right, saka yung mem to range na control line,
kasama siya dito. So, for the right back,
kailangan sa group niya, kasama yung red right na control line, and the mem to range.
Ibig sabihin, okay, itong right back na to, itong dalawang lines na to, okay, ito yung sa
red right saka mem to range.
You get the idea? Okay, so you simply have to analyze. So, nasa right back na, ano yung mga controllers na kailangan mo, okay? So, ganun lang basically. Okay, rin ba yun? So, we'll stop here because we finish yung part ng pipeline control. The next part will be yung ano, yung specific na sa data hazard. Okay? And we're going to use, of course, yung sinasabi ko kanina, yung multi-cycle na
para malaman natin yung
okay, but we'll discuss this after the exam. Okay? So, no more questions. So, please study hard and don't forget to solve the problems
on the textbook because expect that questions will be coming from us.
Okay, so please wash your paper and then
the coverage
is until dito sa ano, hanggang dito sa overview ng ano. Pipeline summary sa book.
Meron yan sa
Oh, hindi na kasama nung specific sa leg V8 na ano, na 5 by data. Yung general concept ng 5 by data.